Part of the mission of the National Center for Spectator Sports Safety and Security is to look at major issues in the industry and really work within the industry, the shareholders, in creating best practices. Back in April of 2013, we had an incident in Boston, as all of you know, that triggered our industry to step back the next week at the National Sports Safety and Security Summit for Marathons and look at the shareholders coming here, about over 100 top marathon personnel in the country coming here to discuss best practices and actually develop best practices. So it's a significant step for the industry. It's an important role of the center playing in modifying environments such as marathons to improve the risk assessments and of those events. So we look forward to having representatives from New York Marathon to our Jackson Marathon, all scalable sizes of the marathons coming here next week to sit down and develop these best practices. The format for best practices development really requires these 100 shareholders to come in and go through these six discussion areas to for us to synthesize important segments for the development of the best practices. And these six topics that they're going to discuss came about through last year at our conference. We had a symposium. We accumulated information there from national surveys, et cetera. So we're looking at these areas. The first one is obviously the event day itself. What in the planning of it, the actual day itself and the post part of it, what are the requirements necessary? What best practices need to make sure that the event day is secure? Crowd dynamics and crowd management. How do we look at start and finish? How do we handle crowds of over a million in New York Marathon, for instance, over 26 miles? What is the role of video surveillance and information, social media, et cetera? We're going to look at emergency action planning. If something would happen, what are the right protocols and procedures that we'll be able to react as quickly as we can with the right personnel, the right resources to save lives? We'll be talking about risk and threat assessments. And most of these major events, for instance, the United States, going back 6 months prior to the event, looking at threat levels, looking at what information is coming from different government agencies, FBI, what threats do we need to worry about in preparation of the event. And then staff development, it takes hundreds of volunteers from medical to line staff of ticket takers in the start finish area. How do you train these people? What goes into the training? What are the components? And then finally, an area that's emerging is technology. How can we use, what technology should we be thinking about so that we can combine technology with the staff and with processes so that as we go down the road, how does technology play a role in making these events safe and secure? The key to this whole process will be the balance between safety, security, and the event, so that the runners are protected. In this country, last year in marathons, we had 541,000 people cross the finish line in marathons. We had 1,100 marathons in this country this past year. So there's a lot of runners, a lot of city agencies. There is sponsors, branding to worry about. And there's certainly the protection of the runners and the those operating the event. So it's a big undertaking in this country. It's massive. Through the efforts of the center here to attract the quality of people here the next week is to do something of a paradigm change in the industry so that they'll have a best practices that are what they call a living document. So it's very, very important.